Welcome to GC Reddy Technologies, SQL versus NoSQL Databases. First, introduction to NoSQL. I think all of you familiar with SQL, Structured Query Language. Now, introduction to NoSQL. NoSQL is an approach to database design that can accommodate a wide variety of data models, including key value, document, columnar, and graph formats. NoSQL, which stands for not only SQL, is an alternative to traditional relational databases in which data is placed in tables and data schema is carefully designed before the database is built. NoSQL databases are especially useful for working with large sets of distributed data. Okay. Next, difference between SQL and NoSQL databases. In the world of database technology, there are two main types of databases, SQL and NoSQL, or you can say relational databases and non-relational databases. The difference speaks to how they are built, the type of information they store, and how they store it. Relational databases are structured like phone books that store phone numbers and addresses, etc. Non-relational databases are document-oriented and distributed, like file folder that hold everything from a person's address and phone number to their Facebook likes and online shopping preferences, etc. Next, examples for SQL and NoSQL databases. First, popular SQL databases and RDBMSs, relational database management systems. One is MySQL, the most popular open source database, excellent for CMS sites and blogs. Next, Oracle, an object relational database management system written in the C++ language. If you have the budget, this is a full service option with great customer service and reliability. Oracle has also released an Oracle NoSQL database. Next, third one, IBM DB2. DB stands for database. IBM DB2, a family of database server products from IBM that are built to handle advanced big data analytics. Next, fourth one, Sybase, a relational model database server for businesses, primarily used on the Unix OS, which was the first enterprise level DBMS for Linux environment. Next, fifth one, MS SQL Server, Microsoft SQL Server, a Microsoft developed RDBMS for enterprise level databases that supports both SQL and NoSQL architectures. Next, sixth one, MariaDB, an enhanced drop-in version of MySQL. Next, seventh one, PostgreSQL, an enterprise level object relational DBMS that uses procedure languages like Perl and Python in addition to SQL level code. Next, popular NoSQL databases, MongoDB, the most powerful NoSQL system, especially among startups, a document-oriented database with JSON-like documents in dynamic schemas instead of relational tables that's used on the back end of sites like eBay, Foursquire, etc. It is open source, so it is free with good customer support. Next, second one, Apache CouchDB, a true DB for the web. It uses the JSON data exchange format to store its documents. JavaScript for indexing, combining and transforming documents. And HTTP, Hypertext Transfer Protocol, for its API. Next, third one, HBase, another Apache project developed as a part of Hadoop. This open source non-relational column store NoSQL DB is written in Java and provides big table like capabilities. Next, fourth one, Oracle NoSQL, Oracle's entry into the NoSQL category. Next, fifth one, Apache's Cassandra DB. Born at Facebook, Cassandra is a distributed database that is great at handling massive amounts of structured data. Anticipate a growing application. Cassandra is excellent at scaling up examples, Instagram, Comcast, Apple, and Spotify, etc. Thank you.